Welcome to this demonstration of the cosmic bubble. In this demo, I will give you some background information on the cosmic bubble and show you how to create one yourself. The cosmic bubble has been created by the cloud team at Shubukphilos to enable cloud orchestration development, or rather production-like testing, in an isolated environment. When looking at the architecture, the bubble infrastructure is created by the bubble cookbook, like for example networking, and the Bubble Toolkit is used to create a cloud orchestration platform within this isolated environment. In this demo, the cloud orchestration platform is Cosmic, but the Cookbook and Toolkit also support CloudStack. When looking more closely at the bubble from a virtualization perspective, we see this diagram. For this demo, I will be using a KVM hypervisor in our cloud, where I've created a VM, here in black, using CentOS 7.2. Instead of a VM, this can also be hardware, like for example a small Intel NUC. See the README in the Bubble Cookbook for more requirements on this. This machine, or VM, is what we refer to as the Bubble and will be configured by the Bubble Cookbook. The Bubble Toolkit will be used to create the isolated cloud environment, namely a VM which runs the Cosmic Cloud Orchestration software, create one or more hypervisors, which will be KVM in this demo, but it can also be Zen Server. Deploy the so-called data center configuration in Cosmic and add the KVM hypervisors to the Cosmic configuration. After this, Cosmic will start system VMs on the added hypervisors and you are basically ready to start the Marvin tests or just use a web interface to do some manual testing. But let's start with the actual demo now. So, let me set up a connection to the machine on which we're going to let the Bubble Cookbook converge. There's the estate session. Have a look at the cookbook. There we go. Quick look at the README. Here's a nice picture of the bubble in action. You actually see here two hypervisors, KVM, with a lot of VMs. And in this case, it's running Apache CloudStack. And it's running on top of a Intel NUC. The requirements, the cookbook attributes, and here's the usage. We are going to provision a single machine without the presence of a chef server or a chef server environment. And in this specific case, we're going to use Kitchen. So let's have a look at the README. The README and the script are actually located within the same repository as the Bubble Cookbook. And here we have the installation, comply with the requirements, of course. Download and run the pre-installed script. I think I know what's in that script, so I'm just gonna copy paste it in here and it's running. So let's have a quick look at what the script actually does. I'll not cover each line in detail. But it basically installs some packages we're going to need. It's going to install ChefDK because ChefDK contains, among other things, Test Kitchen, which we're going to use. The script will clone the repository, of course, of the cookbook, which we're going to use. And here it's going to set some environment variable to use a specific kitchen configuration file. And it will give some feedback to the user, which we need to execute. And this is one step, which will be convenient also later on. And that's providing your SSH public key to the environment and let the cookbook take care of provisioning it to the user. So let's do that. So the script actually finished, the steps here again, and we're going to edit this file. Now specifically, we're going to need to change the user to your liking. Public key, of course, let me look that up. There it is. And you can change the comment if you want, but it's fine for now. Then it's basically two steps left, kitchen converge and reboot. For this moment, I'm going to make a small sidestep, because you need to make sure that your VM or system has enough disk space, and in this case, the default image of the VM I'm using doesn't have that. So I provisioned an additional disk, and I can let the cookbook also take care of adding that disk, formatting that disk, and placing it at the right mount point. So all for images that Cosmic is going to download, the templates is going to download for the system VMs, and the primary storage, secondary storage, where it will place the VMs you're going to create, it will place that on that mount point or disk for me. So that's it. So now it's kitchen converge. And remember, after that, it's going to be reboot. And that's it. So now kitchen is starting, and kitchen will use Bergshelf to resolve all the dependent cookbooks. And kitchen will then start chef client. Chef actually consisting out of chef zero, which is basically a mockup of a chef server, in which the cookbooks will be loaded, attributes will be loaded, and the chef client will make use of. Well, this is going to take about 5 minutes, so we'll let this run and come back when it's finished. So the chef run finished. It took about 6 minutes, and if you remember, the last step of the instruction was reboot. So we're gonna let it reboot. It needs to reboot because some services need to be restarted or reloaded. We might fix that in some later version of the cookbook. If you happen to know exactly which services we could already restart during the chef run, please feel free to have a look at the cookbook and edit that at the right place, and send in a pull request, because all pull requests are more than welcome. Let me set up a new connection. So here's a new connection. Next thing is that we're going to use the Bubble Toolkit to actually deploy a cloud platform, the Cosmic Cloud platform, within this bubble. So let's check out the Bubble Toolkit. Here it is. Bubble Toolkit. It was initially created for testing Cloudsec or Cosmic pull requests. And we're going to use parts of this, like for example, preparing the management server. So we need to go into this location. And I'm going to start a screen in case we get disconnected. And the first thing to do is deploy a management server, in which we are going to build the Cosmic application. Next thing is that we're also going to deploy KVM hypervisors. Here you see a configuration file, which we are also going to use later on, or is also very convenient when testing, as this basically describes the Cosmic data center configuration which we are using. In this case, it's mainly used to specify that we're going to use two KVM servers. There we go. Okay, this will take some time, so I can show you some other configurations, some other features, like for example the built-in VPN connection, which is here. We have a soft Ether VPN server component by default running in the bubble or in the VM which we created, which allows us to create a layer 2 tunneling protocol or just use the soft Ether VPN client. And I'm gonna connect there, get this one quickly. VPN connection is established and I've got an IP address. So this basically means that my network is now directly connected to the network within the bubble or within this virtual machine. To be able to create this connection, I needed to open up the cloud where this VM is running, use port forwarding, firewall, but now I have a VPN directly to this machine. So let's see if that works. This will be the local address. That's what here. So there's a connection there. I'm going to log on using the user ID I specified previously, and it should take care of my key, which it did. So I'm basically now connected with a direct connection. This will be useful also later on. Once we'll come to that. One thing to notice is that now I have a direct connection and I can also connect to, for example, the management server later on, if that's running. But be sure to shield your bubble from direct access, because access or security within the bubble is fairly limited, basically to enable testing better, faster connections. So mind you, take care of the security outside of the bubble. Okay. So while this is running, I can also show you that this is actually basically a KVM instance. So these are the VMs which are running there. The CS1 is the management server we're going to use for the Cosmic application. And if you have your X server configuration locally done, then you should be able to also get X client, and in the end you should be able to look up this as well. So you actually see here this VM booting, which is located in my case within this VM, which is running on a KVM hypervisor. So I hope it doesn't confuse people, but it is what it is. So that's rebooting. It'll probably come up very soon. And at which point we have a connection. Okay. So I don't need this one anymore. This one. That one. So we're basically now ready to start compiling Cosmic. How do we do that? Well, we could have a quick look at the Cosmic site. This is here, the Cosmic repository, and building from source. Something important about SSH keys, which I'll cover in a minute. And this basically gives you instructions on how to build and run Cosmic. We're going to use the help scripts for that. So let's first go into the location where the help scripts are present for Cosmic. We'll start a screen here as well in case we get disconnected. Enlarge it a bit. First thing is that we're going to clone the repository. It's called Prepare Cosmic Compile. And here it's trying to authenticate GitHub. And you probably know that this checkout is being done via the SSH protocol and not via the HTTPS protocol. And we do it by default, so it enables us to make commits back to the repository, and of course create pull requests after that. So that helps in development process. Okay, so that's cloning the repositories. It's done. So the next step is actually letting it build. So that's the build run deploy test. Part of this is also the not only building and running, but also deploying the data center configuration. And as I've shown before, we have a configuration file which specifies the data center. In this case, it's a zone with 1 and 2 KVM servers, which could be Zen server or just 1 KVM server. There are separate configurations files for there. Let me add a timer there so we can see how much time it takes to actually build this. And let it run. So this is going to take a while. It's going to compile the complete Cosmic application. It's going to deploy the data center configuration. Script will also take care of installing the Cosmic agents into the KVM servers. Cosmic will edit and we'll let the script run and continue when it's finished. Okay. Let's have a look. The script apparently finished. As one of the last steps, it checked the availability of a template, which is mostly an indication that the underlying infrastructure is actually ready and operating. So that's basically it. The Cosmic Cloud environment is up and running, and you can run your tests against it. Or perhaps show you briefly. You can use the web interface. This is exactly one of the advantages of using the VPN, because I can now access the web interface directly. And this is also one of the reasons I mentioned security, because Cosmic has been implemented with a default username password. So there we are. Have a look at the infrastructure. It seems fairly complete. There are two hypervisors here, the system VMs. They are up and running. So you can deploy your environment now. Well, let's do a very quick deployment of. Note that we're still missing a network configuration. So we'll let all create one. So it's gonna now it's gonna create a guest network. There we are. For this, it needs to spin up a virtual router. Which it's doing there. Once that's been created and running, it will actually start deploying the VM, this instance. And that's basically it. So, what did we actually need to do to get this isolated Cosmic Cloud platform? I guess a lot of information and screens rushed by, but basically we managed to create this in about 9 steps. First using the Bubble cookbook. The first step was to execute a one-liner from the README to install ChefDK and clone the cookbook repository. The second step was the modification of the JSON file to include our public SSH key, followed by a kitchen converge and a reboot. After this, we used Bubble Toolkit, deployed a VM for the management server, deployed two VMs for two KVM hypervisors, SSH into the management server, and prepared or did a checkout of the Cosmic repo, and did a build, run, and deploy of the Cosmic data center. So, what can we actually do now? Well, besides being able to demo this nested hypervisor technology going three levels deep, we now have an isolated cloud where you can make code changes to the cloud orchestration program itself and run this in an isolated yet fairly production-like environment. After making these changes and testing them for yourself, you can easily run integration tests before committing back to the community via pull requests. Or you can even build your continuous integration pipeline, for example, with Jenkins, like we actually did for the Cosmic Cloud development. But if you develop software against the cloud, which I myself do, for example, for the Vagrant CloudStack plugin, you can instantly build a cloud to develop against. Or, of course, you can learn how to operate a cloud like Cosmic or CloudStack with full privileges without the risk of bringing down your production environment. So, if you want to learn more about the Bubble Cookbook Toolkit or the Cosmic Cloud, here are some useful links where you can find this information. Well, I guess that's all, folks. In case you're curious, my name is Bob, and I hope you found this demonstration useful. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.